Let's just keep playing g6. It's what I usually do when I need to win games. Okay, let's play the beef eater. Okay, he decides to decline the beef eater. Let's go knight c6. Guess I'll go here and just castle maybe. They achieved Smeagol for the 2 months. I used to achieve Smeagol, the beef eater. Yep, it's a good opening. It's very meaty. Let's go here and take, I guess, or take in here. Maybe I'll go e6 and ed5 even. I think I'll play a6, b5 here. Have I been to Jito? You mean the sushi shop in the train station in Tokyo? No, I've never been there. In fact, I only know one person who's been there, and they said that it was overrated. They said that the experience was just weird. Okay, I take. Okay, this guy's very serious. Okay, let's just open it up. Actually, maybe takes, I go knight f6. This is gonna be very weird. Alireza playing on his phone, I assume that's a joke, right? Now I can obviously take. I think I just take. He takes and I go knight f6. I mean, queen b5, I always have e4, but I think I go rook b8 to hit the queen and knight f6 back. Trying to open up the center of the board here, basically. Queen f3, okay, let's go rook b4. I do need to be very aggressively active here to try and open up the middle of the board. Let's go here. Maybe I take with a bishop and go knight d6. Very, very weird position. Okay, first of all, there's a free pawn on b2. Secondly, I have knight d6. Do I just take? I'm just going to take this pawn. It looks like a free pawn, so I might as well take it. The one logical move. It's actually quite sharp and quite tricky. I think I have to go here. He does have fg6, hg6, and something. Who is this? This is an FM or is this some IM? I don't know who this is. He takes with a bishop. Take with a pawn. I think I actually have to take with a pawn. I don't really like what I've done. This actually might be really bad. This might be really bad. I might have to go for a queen trade, actually. Gotta be very careful. Okay, let's go. Wait, I can't go rook d8. Okay, let's go here, maybe in rook d4. This is really bad. Okay, I have to close this diagonal, or not diagonal, this file. Goes h3, that's actually not, that can't be the right move. Feels like the wrong move. I feel like he finally blundered, but, how do I play this? So I have rook d8, which is a move. Okay, I'm definitely in the game here. If I find the right move, is it queen a7? No, it's not queen a7. I'm just gonna go here. Queen c6 was a move, but it would have been a draw if I had done that, so I don't want to make a draw. Okay, I can't take, but I think I can go here maybe. I think I go here and just take, and I should be winning. Just take with the H pawn. Okay, now I think I'm gonna win. Yeah. Pawn is too fast, surely. Yeah, four connected and I get the win. Thank you to Haggis McGee for the 4 months. Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Pretty tough game, actually, there. It felt like he played a perfect game for the most part. And then, like, somewhere, like, he started thinking for long periods of time and started blundering. Very weird. Where's Dania? He's probably still playing. Yeah, he's still playing. He's going to win, I assume. He is up. No, he's not actually. It's even material, but his opponent is very slow too. Yeah, Big Fish is not playing this week. Neither is Artemyev, I don't think. If I'm not mistaken. Yeah, I don't see Big Fish or Artemyev here. Yeah. Should be winning. Knight c7 and maybe this probably isn't winning with correct play, but this probably is a draw with correct play, but Daniel's gonna win just because the knight is better than the bishop here. Maybe h5. I definitely h5. I feel like you should go h5 and try to reroute the knight. Yeah, he's going, okay. Okay, you take, king f4. This is obviously a draw with correct play. But correct play is a very loose term. So king g5, king h5. Not king h6, of course. Knight d3 should be winning, I think. Bishop g1 maybe. He's got a move. What's he doing? h5. Oh, now king g4 wins. Yeah, now just king g4 and you win. King g4? King g4? King g4, Dania? Wow. He's gonna win, but man, crazy game. Crazy game. Really close, really close. Oh, no, Nora Speedo says, what is the best ever winning opening? Thanks for the answer. I don't know. I would guess the Spanish, probably the Ruy Lopez, but I don't know. That's my guess, but I don't know. Daniel started seeing Alireza, maybe. I mean, that was a weird game. Spanish opening is the Ruy Lopez, you guys. That's what the Spanish opening is. Thank you, Chubtar, for the 5 months as well. It's got to be the Spanish, though. What happened to the house tour that I promised? I was not at the place where I am now. So that was before, and I think I did show it. So yeah, Alireza, Daniel, we all won our first game. There's still probably, what, two games left? Okay, here we go. Next game. Okay, let's play H3 for the memes. Let's go H3. Thank you to Nili Afi for the Prime. Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Thank you, Nili Afi. Okay, he plays the E5. He goes... Okay, I can play D4. Let's play Knight F3, Knight D4, maybe. Play D3. I don't know if H3 is good or bad, but I'm going to do this. H3 is the all-time winningest move? Definitely not. Okay, let's go... Play g3 and bishop g2, maybe. He's gonna go c5, I assume. I think it freeze and twitch with the prime. Thanks so much, freeze and twitch. Appreciate it. Thank you. Okay, let's go here. Now, the pawn's on h3 already, so it's actually quite decent for me, I think. Let's go here and takes. I guess I'll take with a c pawn. It leads to more complicated positions. G4, F4. E4 is good. Do I want to do it right away? Yeah, I think I do. I can also go knight A4 here. I'm going to do it. Why is H3 so bad if it's played visually? It probably isn't that bad, honestly. Yeah, obviously I just take. I think I just go queen c2 and like rook d. Oh, he can take. Should have played bishop e3. Very stupid. He doesn't take though. Do I want to go rook e1 is a question. I think I do want to go rook e1. I also want to go knight d4 at some moment. I just don't know when. Okay, plays h6, and now I think after knight d4 I should be clearly better. Oh, he's got queen b4 though, which I missed. I guess I have bishop e3 though, so it's fine. Now we can play a two bishops versus two knights game, but I don't really want to do that right away. So then I'm just going to play. Can also go. Actually, I think I'm going to go b3, bishop b2, and go for the double op combo with both x's. Thank you, Joppy, for the 2 months. Thank you so much to Joppy. Appreciate it. Thank you, man. Okay, he goes queen c5. I can obviously trade. I think I don't want to trade, though, if I can help it. But it's kind of hard. Okay, fine. Let's just, Definitely don't want to trade here. So I'll go here. Maybe rook d1 and bishop e3. X, let him know. Yeah, okay, now I think I can actually start developing. I can play f4. Wait, f4 might just win. Wait, f4, I think f4 just wins. Knight here, I go f5. Knight g6, I go f5, and he's gonna lose material here, so it should be game over. Okay, I go f5, trap the bishop. Do I recommend the London for beginners? I think it's a reasonable opening. What's an X? An X is a streamer from Canada. That's what an X is. Thank you to Madcap Power Shot for the Prime. Thank you so much, Madcap Power Shot. I think I just take. So I'm hitting the knight too. Okay, it goes there. Okay, now I should be winning. I think I'm just. Not so obvious, actually. I can't go knight f5. I could also just play bishop f4, maybe. I think I'm just going to play positional here with bishop f4 and bishop e5. I think you did a hero tram for the 7 months, and now I just moved the king out of the way. And even though I gave him two pawns, it's much more stable than the other line, which looked very messy. Rook e1. Can take e6 if I want. I think it's just winning. Yeah, because if knight g4, I just go king h1. And eventually this extra bishop is going to play a role. Let's go here. Again, I'm willing to trade materials. Just go rook d1. Just technically win this game now. No nonsense. Let's just go, I don't know, bishop f3 is good. Maybe just queen d2 to take the file. Queen e5, logical. Let's go here, try to trade some queens. I think I can just... can obviously take, but... do I want to? Surely it's good enough, but I'm just going to go back just to be safe. Let's just open this up. Goes h5. He wants h4. I don't really want to give him h4. I'm just going to go here. I can play g4 here. I can also just take, I guess. No reason it's not good enough. Just king. I can move my king. I don't necessarily have to, but I'm just going to positionally win this game. Can take and go knight h5, rook e7. Probably good enough, but I'm just going to go check. Go here, pin the tail on the donkey. I can obviously take e4 again. I can also just go like check. I'm just going to go here on queen d3. Yeah, Alireza won a second game. Yeah, I know. I mean, basically, I'm just taking a very super slow, methodical approach here and just going for the technical win. He goes g6. I can obviously trade. I mean, everything is winning here. It's a question of what's the best technical way to win. This is probably the best technical way here. So I have rook f7 check and queen g6. Let's go check. And he's actually just made it. I check. And I have mate on g5. Thank you to Tribunian Prime. Thank you so much for the Prime. Thank you to CCM for the 3. Colby Cheeser for the 2. Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Yeah, that was a pretty good game. It's a good win. Next game should be starting pretty soon. Or Daniel's still playing. Okay. Daniel is going to draw somehow. He's gonna lose. He's gonna lose king e7. He's gonna lose queen. It's queen a7. Queen e3. Everything wins. Oh man. Wow. Wow, Daniel, tough day. I mean, he came very close to messing up that first game, so I guess it's not a shock, in a way, but brutal, brutal. So Dan is the first top player, and actually losing a round 2 is pretty sad. Normally, like, I mean, you always don't want to lose, but if you lose, you want to lose like at least like after like round 4, round 5. He's not out of the running. He still could come back, but I'm not sure he's gonna keep playing. I mean, if he wins out, he can definitely come back, but winning out is gonna be pretty rough. Now he gets nice pairings, exactly. Yeah, so he could get like 5 or 6 easy pairings before he's another tough game. Yeah, I mean, I had the second camera on, but that was back when I was at TSM, and I'm at a different location now, so I don't want to give away where, because I'm streaming from home now, so I don't want to give away where I am, because that kind of could give away something potentially. And the last thing you want to do is like get doxxed or anything. Azrael Chess is Shakur Mamadiarov, yeah. Thank you to Billy for the Prime. Thank you to Sprices for the 4 months. Thank you to Agathama for the $3. I know where you live, the USA. USA is a big country, you guys. Have I ever been to Wales? No, I've never been to Wales. Okay, next game should be starting. Oh, there's still one game going. The break is after round four, yeah. Next event is the next Magnus event. It should be end of April, maybe in May. Who knows? Why am I no longer at the TSM office? I've already spoken about that at length before. Mm-hmm. There we go. All right, next game should be starting in 1 second. Okay, round three. Okay, tough pairing around for round three. Okay. Keep going G6. I think I played this guy in Arena Kings last night too. Actually, I had D5. I guess I'm gonna go Bishop B7 maybe. I can always play D5 and draw, but the problem is it's Title Tuesday and a draw is not going to get it done here. So I kind of need to play for something more. D5 is always a drawing option in these lines. But I can't really play something stable here. I need to win this game. Draw is not going to cut it. Did I ever see Manny Pacquiao play chess? No, I did not. It goes A5. Okay, let's play B5. Takes. I don't really want to take with a pawn. I think I'm gonna do something dubious. Again, I'm gonna stick to my strategy of trying to play more on the edge in this game. So I'm gonna take with a rook. Why is Levy never playing Title Tuesday? I mean, I think it's a tough event to play in, honestly. It's not an easy event to play. I think I'm just going to drop back, maybe. Is C4... I'm going to drop back so I can play D5. How do I know it's already a draw? Well, it's not that it's a draw. It's that it's a simplification in a position where my opponent probably can't lose. I'm completely fine. I won't lose the game, but I can't win because a lot of pieces come off the board. That's why I can't. That's why I'm not playing like that. Can go rook c8 here with c5. I actually kind of want to play c5 here, but I'm sure it's bad. Definitely don't want to play knight d7. I'm gonna go here to force the knight away. I'm gonna go here now and takes. Now I'm gonna go c5 next move probably. I'm definitely gonna play. Oh, I thought I could play c5, but maybe it's no good here. Probably it's not. Again, it's too drawish if I play c5, so I'm gonna take. Even though I don't want to do this, it's too drawish if I play it the other way. I can actually maybe go c5 here. Or do I just no? Probably I just go back target this. A knight e5 is also maybe a move. Go here. I want to go c5 d5. A lot of ideas to open up the position. This is also the hardest part about Title Tuesday, is that sometimes you need to get very risky and not do what is precise. Thought I had d5 here. I do, but it's I'm gonna do I go for broke already? It's very early in the tournament. I can take him probably. I'm fine, but do I want to go for broke is the question. Let's see. Bishop 8. My instinct is that I probably should not go for broke, so I think I'm just gonna stay. I think I'm gonna stabilize. If I draw the game, I draw the game. But it's I think it's too risky. I just think it's too risky to go for broke this early. He plays rook c1. That's actually a strange move. I think that's not the best move. Again, I probably can't win though. But maybe, you know what, if that's just life. If I can't win, I can't win every game. But I can't lose. A loss is a lot worse than a draw. Here, so if I draw a game, I'm still very much in it. Whereas a loss here, I'm very much not in it. Of course, maybe I just blundered. I don't know. Let's take. I mean, I feel like I have checks here. I don't know if I have enough, though. Let's see. I might sack even. I also have knight h5, knight g3, which looks very dangerous too. Let's take and go here. I mean, again, he has queen c3 and it's just a draw, but that's just, yeah, it's just, I'm just gonna have to make a draw here if I can. Actually, it's not a guaranteed draw. Wait, why did I do this? I might have just blundered. Oh, I might have actually really just blundered. Yikes. Yeah, I did just blunder. I'm still probably okay here, but I think I can draw this at least. Okay, rook b8. Okay, actually I can go here though. So I stop rook d7, no knight c5. I can draw the game, but I should be, if I play this well, I'm going to draw. If I play this badly, I might still lose. But I shouldn't actually lose this now. Do I want to go h5 or g5 is the question. I'm just going to go like, let's go h5. Plays h4, which I think is not precise. Let's go here. Let's go here, hit the pawn. I have knight d5 also as a threat. Or did I just blunder? Oh my gosh, I just blundered. Just blundered. Wow. Let's go here, kick the rook off of there. Gonna have to try to get something tricky here. How do I draw this? This is actually not easy to draw. Let's go here. I think I'm still drawing, but I really misplayed this. I think I just go here. To be very precise here. He has knight c7, but this should be a draw. This is still a draw if I play this correctly. Let's go here. Still a draw. Okay, now I can just trade though, I think. Now it's just a draw. Again, there's increment, so because there's increment, I can't flag him, but I can't lose either. Yeah, okay. So, of course, it's the end game between Daniil Dubov and Magnus Carlsen. Yeah, okay. Terrible game. But I really never had chances to win. I guess in retrospect, I should have just tried to force a draw in the opening with d5 somewhere. Like, there were multiple options. I think maybe it was around here when I had d5, or I had d5, maybe even here. But the thing is, when you go d5, everything basically comes off the board. You end up in a situation like this, where it's completely equal, but you can't win because everything's off the board. So that's why I didn't play d5. In retrospect, I probably should have, because I got the draw anyway, but it was very shaky. Somewhere around here, I should have had something. Let me see. Did I have something better? Right around here. It's already bad. C5 was the right move. I wanted to play C5 in this game, and then I didn't do it. Oh wow, I have takes, and I have this, and knight d5. Wow, knight b4. Okay. Knight b4. Wow. Wow, that's pretty brutal. I didn't even see that. That's good. Knight f3. I think Mason returns for the give. Sub Julian Fox for the 2. Benji Boy for the 3. Big Fat Gypsy Monkeys for the 2. Roger the Rock with the prime, Sergeant Plug with the prime, Mark Donovan with the prime. Yeah, I mean, that's just brutal. I saw c5, but of course I didn't see knight d5. It's there. Let's do this one. Yeah, Stockfish OP, no kidding. It's crazy. Let's go here. Takes, interesting choice. I think I'm supposed to stay with the queen and go knight c3. There's d5. I think takes is just bishop g2 and e3, as I recall. It just castles. There's rook e8. I think rook c1 is a move here. Or rook d1. Which one is right? I think rook d1 is right. Oh, I'm still very much in this, obviously, but the point is that it got way too unhappy for me versus what it should have been. Let's go here. I think I'm gonna play queen. Actually, don't know where to go. I'm gonna go to c2, even though probably it's wrong. Maybe what am I doing? Okay, let's focus. Let's just go here. Maybe hit the rook on c8. I know who Indian Elephant is. Yeah, I've played him. I used to play him a lot on the internet chess club in the old days. You can afford 2 draws objectively. I would say about 2 draws, but not more than 2. I'm gonna go here in b4 maybe. Goes knight f8, which I think is not right, because now I think I get knight e5. Goes bishop c8, logical. Is there some weird? I'm gonna just go back. Goes there. Okay, now I start to launch on the queen side. It starts to get a little bit nasty here, I think. C8, interesting. Should wait, b5 takes. Okay, I'm gonna go a4, idea b5, so I can take and plant the knight on c6. Okay, then I go here, because now this is actually getting really ugly for black, because d5 is also very weak now from the knight and the bishop. This is a big problem for black. Knight c6, and I plant the knight, although he does have a6 to undermine it maybe in a move or two. Thank you, Tim Bobanga, for the prime. Thank you, Tim Bobanga. Appreciate it. Thank you. He does it. I'm going to go here. goes a5, which also looks very wrong. That looks extremely wrong. There's got to be something here that I'm missing. This is it e4, knight e4? I mean, e4 is begging to be played. Let's just do it, because I can take. I also have d5. It looks very dubious for my opponent. So let's just open it all up here with d5. I also have d6 here coming as well with knight e7. Oh, he just resigns. That's kind of nice. Oh, that's really nice. He just resigns. Okay, clean win. Good game. Basically, he moves the bishop. Like, here I just go d6. And the problem is I'm threatening knight e7, and his king is actually kind of stuck here. So he has to, like, take, and he's just getting mated every which way. So yeah, there's also a beautiful checkmate. So takes, knight e7, king can't move, of course, because queen covers both of these squares. Takes, pawn takes, bishop takes knight, and then you go queen h8. You sack the queen and make a new queen for a new checkmate, which is pretty beautiful too. That's also really nice. That would have been really beautiful to get that sack in the corner pocket, and then take the knight with mate. That would have been really nice, but anyway, pretty good stuff. We got the win 3.5 out of 4. Let's watch Alireza's game. Is there a benefit to resigning instead of checkmate? Not really, other than you feel like it's out of respect, you don't do it. Okay, Alireza's doing well here. Although it's still tricky. Knight e2, knight h5, not clear. Knight h5. Okay, maybe knight g3. Knight g3, knight d5 with knight f4 with the big fork and the fossil. Okay, so now you've just moved the king. King h6 or king g7. Black's got to move, though. Black does not have time here. I think Alireza is in trouble this game, by the way. Rook's, there's a free knight. Wait, there's... Oh, rook c1? Oh wait, no, the knight was not free because there's bishop b3. That wasn't a mouse slip, actually. That was intentional. I would just go f4 or g4 here, just attack. Okay, so trade. Black has to trade. Black's got to move. Just take. Gotta move. F4. Just go F4. 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 Wow. Queen D3. FE3. I think this is losing. FE3. Queen C4. Move. Move. Queen B5. Move. Queen moves. Move. FE3. Wow. E3. Queen b2, bishop e3, check, gotta move. King g8, it's gonna be a draw. King g7, draw. Wow, what a draw. King g8, yeah, just no messing around, just king g7. What is black trying to win now? King d4. King G7. Yeah, this is a draw. King G8. Yeah, black's not gonna move now. King F8. King F7. King D7. King C6. King C5. Move. King C5. King B4. Check, and black's gonna. King D4. Yeah, crazy. Somehow he blundered this whole thing. That should not have been a win for Alireza, but he gets the win because his opponent didn't stick around. Basically, what happened is the reason Alireza wins this game is because the guy doesn't stick around. If the guy sticks around with King G8, it's always a draw. But at some point after like 20 moves of drawing, he decided that he didn't want to stick around and he was going to try to win, which is very weird conceptually. I mean, they both kind of threw there in a way. But the thing was, when you've defended for 20 moves and your whole idea is to sit around and wait, you can't suddenly change your mind after that. That's the thing. You have to just sit around and wait. Once you've done that for like 10 moves, you can't decide, okay, well, now I'm going to start trying to win the game. You basically have to just keep sitting and stick to your planning. Blitz especially. I mean, he was obviously winning earlier. I think where he really went wrong was right here. There was this moment right here, just fe3 is game over, because you just have rook f1 and rook h1 and it's just game over. I mean, this is what he really did. He did it to get time on his clock. Well, who are you saying did it to get time? Because the thing is, if you look at it, I mean, Alireza of course defended very well there from the bad position, but the thing is, he wasn't actually gaining time, because if you notice, his clock was sitting at 2 seconds. I mean, there was only one obvious one under the time circumstance. Like, he should have seen the fe3. This one he should have seen. This is the only win that I feel like he should have seen under the circumstances. All the other wins probably I don't think were really that clear cut. If we go back to like here, yeah, like already, like, yeah, this was very strange. Actually, I don't know why he didn't take with the rook. That's actually very obvious. That's very, very weird. But then, yeah, after this, everything else is very tricky. Yeah, it's amazing that, see, like, he sits around 20 moves and then he decides to try to come out, whereas he should just keep sitting on G8. Anyway, they need a Gore for the 4, they need a Webster for the prime. I think we're on a break here, if I'm not mistaken. Are there any games? Wait, there's still games going? No, I don't think there are any games going. Rook h1 instead of queen f4, was that a mate? I didn't see, I don't see the game anymore. So yeah, I think there's going to be a break, and so we'll come back in a couple of minutes and we keep rolling. Behind me? There's nothing behind me. Okay, so I think we're on this break. Let me reload the page. Yeah, there are no games. So we're on our break. What is that behind me? What? There's a Christmas tree and there's a chessboard behind me. Who is Fairchess? Fairchess on YouTube is that is Dimitri Andraken. Do I play chess? Yes, I play chess. I'm not playing right now because we're on our 6-minute break before round 5 in the tournament. I thought he was a Fall Guys streamer. I played Fall Guys, not recently, but I played Fall Guys. Thank you, Tay 222, for the prime. Thanks so much to Tay. Appreciate it. Thank you for the 3 months. Or sorry, thank you for the prime. Apologies. Do you think people try harder against you because they know you're streaming? Not necessarily, but I think that might apply to everybody who's streaming. What is the gray number below the score? Oh, next to the score, that's the tiebreaker. I have 3.5 points out of 4, so I'm very much in the hunt for it. I had a tough draw, but that's life. All right, tough draw, but that's life. Will I ever collab with the stock guy? I don't really know what there is to collab with. I've looked at it from time to time, but I have a very different philosophy, and I don't know. I mean, does he do actual charting? It feels like he just does a lot of basics. Like, I feel like there are a lot of basics, but I don't see any like specific charting. I feel like he's saying it's going up or it flushes, you know, up. It, you know, there's always like a double top or something, or this sort of things. But I never really see any of that like specific stuff. Okay, this is actually not an easy pairing. Wow. Okay, but again, I have to play more in my more to the spirit of my strengths of what I think is best. I'm not gonna play c6. I'm gonna go d6. Yeah, let's play a6 and b5. Let's go here and bishop b7. Yeah, no, this is strong player. Actually, who he's another FM who's high ranked. Let's go here. Go here. All pretty standard. I always have c6 here. Do I go c6 or not? I think I do go c6 and takes probably. Now I might gambit a pawn. I'm gonna get a little bit chippy here. Okay, he doesn't even want the pawn. Wow. Okay, let's just go. I'm still gonna try to gambit a pawn here. I'm gonna try to bait him into gambiting a pawn or going after me kind of, but he's like not interested. So let's go rook b8. It's a very weird position. I guess I'll just castle. Goes f4. Actually, now I don't like my position. Yeah, I really don't like my position now. Maybe I have c5. e5, knight e8. I think I kind of have to take. Go here, maybe knight d5. Maybe just h6 at some moment as well. I don't like my position at all here. I don't think I've ever played. Maybe I played this guy once or twice, but yeah, I'm not familiar with him at least right off. And now I just blundered e5. Although I do have knight d5, maybe it's not so clear, but it feels bad. Okay, rook f3. Okay, now I've got to do something fast because otherwise this could get really bad really quickly. I think h6 is a move. g5 is a move. Queen a7 looks weird. Doesn't look right at all. e5, knight e4, that's a move. I'm going to go for it. I don't know if it's right. Oh, but now I just blundered bishop f4. Wow. I guess I have queen b7, though, and d4. There's still complications. Let's go here and take. This doesn't look good at all, though. I'm just playing this game badly. This game just has not been a good game. Okay, plays queen e1, which actually I think is not the best move. Shouldn't be the best move, although it's very, very dangerous. Maybe I have g5 here. Got to come with something, though. I really need to come with moves here. I think I'm gonna go for this. I don't know if it's right, but f6, I just take. Takes. Wow. Okay, maybe this just loses for me. Wait, what is he? Wait, he just actually blundered, but he blundered. The position's so bad for me here that it's not even clear that this is okay for me. That's how bad this is. He blundered, kind of. He definitely played something that was not the best move, but My position is so bad here that I might not even be able to survive this. That's how awful this is. I think I'm going to try to run my king out, maybe. Okay, let's think. Fe5, de5. There's nothing. Okay, let's think. King h8, h4. Knight f7. This is so bad that I don't even know how I'm supposed to survive this. Let's go here and pray. Let's pray that somehow I can survive this. Goes e6, which I think is a bad move. I feel like he wants h4, I guess. Is that his idea? Let's go here, hit the knight. Knight h5, rook g8. He's got rook g4, shoot. I had one move there where I probably had something. I just blundered it. Let's go, let's go here. I'm just getting smoked in this game. There's nothing I can do, guys. Got this, and now I have to just... I'm going to lose this game. I have to move fast and basically pray that somehow I can get my bishop out. Unbelievable. Queen h2. Let's go for this. I'm sure I'm losing somehow, but I just have to move quick and pray. Okay, let's go. I just got to move. Just move, just move. I mean, I'm trying to survive. I'm in really bad shape. What's that do? I don't know if it does anything. Go here. Let's go check. Let's go. There we go. Ooh, awful game. Wow. I don't know how I won that game. I don't know how I won that game, but I get the win. He played really well, and where did he really mess it up, though, I wonder? Because it was already getting to, where was it? It was like around here. Yeah, see, this must have been just completely winning, right? Yeah, like f6 is just game over. I just resigned. It's plus four. Yeah, he doesn't do this. He takes. Knight f4 is good. E6 is good. Yeah, I think it's all just losing. Computer just takes time to see this. It's plus seven, yeah. Plus eight. New game didn't start, you guys. New game didn't start, did it? No, there's still games going. Stop trolling me. Stop trolling me, you guys. So this is just plus 10. So rook takes g5 is game over. He goes here, and it's still winning. It's still, yeah, and here he missed knight g6. This is probably the cleanest one. Was takes. Here and then trade, and f6. This is probably the cleanest win with the two passed pawns. But he misses. He goes rook f3 here. Okay. Oh, a knight g6 is mate, and why? Rook h3 takes, and you just go away. Oh, look at this king. This is such a sad king on g7. Yeah, it's just a forced checkmate. Yeah, and then he doesn't, and then yeah, and, oh, it's still mate in seven. What? Oh, because he can take, and then wait, but then what? Knight g6. Oh my god. Ooh. Oh, that is dirty. Oh my gosh. Ooh. Wow, knight g4. Oh man, that is brutal. Yeah, your king is just completely stuck here. Wow. Goes here, still winning. I go here, whereas queen a3 apparently is a draw. Okay, c4. Okay, whatever. Don't want to look at that anymore. Okay, let's play e4. Let's play knight f3, actually. Let's play something a little bit slower. Maybe to Petrov's defense, Senglin and ax6. Let's go here. Brutal. Canadian, yeah, he's from Canada. Mm-hmm. Let's go h4, knight d4 next move. All pretty standard so far. How did I win that game? I know. I already used up my extra lives on that game, so I better not put myself in such situations for the rest of the event. I know f4 is a move here. I know f4 is a move. King b1's also a move. I think King b1's safer. I could be wrong. But yeah, I just used up all my extra lives on that one. Thank you to Dezad Pirate. Thank you to Maxwell Worcester. Let's go f4. Let's just attack. f5, e5. Maybe g4 at some moment, too. Better to be lucky than good. Yes, that is always true. That is always true. Always true. But we'll see. Okay, goes a6. I feel like g4 is a move. I know f5 is also a move at some point. But the thing is, when I play f5, I have to do it in a way where the right tempi match up. Let's just do it anyway. I'm not too worried. Let's go f5. I have knight b3. I have rook e1 maybe. Okay, he goes e5, which I think is a mistake. Do I go knight f3 is the question, or do I take? I think I just take first. And now I go knight c6 and takes, or maybe just knight f3, g4, g5. This is the old God of Kamsky line. Knight b3 is probably good. I think this is good too. The g4, g5 looks very dangerous. I know it's been a while. What do I think of the process of adding wild cards? Well, Julius Baer is doing a separate thing altogether. I think I've got a good position here. Now the question is d5 a threat? That's always a big question. g4, d5 takes, e4, queen e4, bishop c3, dc6, queen b6. That might not be pleasant for me. Can always just, okay, what's the idea? d5 is the idea. d5 takes, e4 is this idea. So if I go rook e1, d5, e5, e4, rook e4. Bishop c3, queen c3, trade. I mean, that's an extra pawn. I don't want to play knight d5 here. I mean, it's probably good, but I don't want to do it. So how do I play this then? Do I go knight d2? No, then d5, knight b3, d4. I can also just go g4. Okay, so I'm not going g4. So what other moves make sense? Knight d5 is a move. What rook h? I think I'm just gonna play rook he1 here. So then on d5 I can just take and go rook e4. Clock is not really a big deal because there's increment. He does it anyway. Wow, I did not expect that. Okay, so first of all, I can take with a pawn. I can also take with a knight. I'm just gonna take with a knight. Hopefully I'm not blundering something here, but I don't think I am because my rook covers e4. It's because e4 I just take with a rook. That's why I put the rook here, specifically to stop this idea, as opposed to like g4, because then he has some e4 and some nastiness with like the queen and the bishop in the right triangle. Okay, rook c5. Knight e5 is a move. I also just d6. He's got what, queen b6? Rook e4 should be good. Okay, he does play e4. I don't really believe that this works for black, but we'll find out, I guess. Oh, I had queen e4 and mate. Oh, that was insane. Oh, that was insane. Wait, but I have knight d4. Wait, okay, don't lose your mind. Stay calm. Don't lose your mind. I have queen e2 here for the mate threat, I think. I also have knight b3. I definitely have... I'm doing well here if I play this correctly. Maybe I just go c3 and g4. I don't love it. Wow. Okay, time does matter, but it shouldn't be a big deal yet. Okay, let's just go c3. Takes... I think I'm just going to go g4. Oh, I blundered bishop h4 now. What am I doing? Oh, my God. Okay, let's go here. Also moving way too slowly again. Yikes. So 6, knight f3, I guess. Okay, let's go here. I have g5 threats. g5 is actually a huge threat because of a mate on h2, maybe. He goes queen b5. Can I ignore it? No, I can't. Okay, let's just take. Just go here and rook f1, maybe. I'm definitely better here because of these bad pawns. I should have played rook e8, probably. Let's go here. Goes there. Strange. Oh, he wants. I think he wants some h5 nonsense. I have g5 threats to me. Okay, what? I just take. He has no double stack because my knight covers and my rook holds the knight. I think I'm much better here. Let's go here. Let's go here. Should be winning now. What am I doing? I just gotta move. Okay, now I think I'm just winning. So I have c6, a6, b4. Check and take. Okay, we get the dub. Another dub. Tough game, but we get the dub. A lot of tough games. Yeah. Thank you, Dr. SS, for the 5, Dark Thunder for the 8, Senjman for the 24. Thank you so much. Yeah, very, 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 very rough game, but I get the win. I don't think that's a friend of Eric's. That's just he's a Romanian Canadian Grandmaster. I've actually never heard of him. Or I hadn't heard of him prior to some of these Title Tuesdays. So I think he's just a very young, talented junior from Canada. Who's leading? There are a couple of people on 6. Dulles, Firouzja, Fandorine. Looks like a strong event, though. 11 rounds, so pretty strong. What the freak? Is started early today? No, we're just chilling. We're rolling. Do I think my rating 3240 is accurate? No, of course not. Either I'm overrated or other people are underrated. I shouldn't be that high up. It's going to be Dubov versus Firouzja next game. And I think I probably play Fandorine as my guess, if I understand the pairing system correctly. Maybe not. Whoa, thank you to Professor Berger for the 10 gifted subs. Thank you so much to Professor Berger. Thank you to Check Raise Flops for 14 months. Thank you so much. So all right, we have two more rounds until the next break. How is Daniel doing? I don't know, actually. I haven't looked. Let me see. He should be, he still should be number two or three, so I should see him. He's online. What's okay? Let's see, how's he done, Daniel Narodinsky? Okay, he, it looks like, has he won every game since then? He lost in the second. Yeah, he won. Yeah, he's won every game since. Yeah. Problem for Daniel though is his tiebreaks are probably terrible now. So he almost has to like win out, because otherwise the tiebreaks just kill you. Oh, I get the, oh, I played, wait, how do I play Dulles and top two guys should play? Oh, that's a terrible pairing, but okay, whatever. Okay, let's go here. Plays rook b1. So again, f6. Okay, they're met. Bishop c4 is what I played in the tour. I'm trying to figure out which line do I want to play against. Do I want to play bishop c4 and like go back into something, or do I want to do something random here? I'm gonna do this one. I'm gonna play the other line. Again, this is not a tour event, so I don't want to show stuff. This is Dubov 100%. Yeah, I think it's even in his username. This is also the danger with playing these sorts of events, is that you end up in these situations where it's like you don't really know what you're supposed to do. Like, do you save your preparation? Do you not save your preparation? Like, it's very tricky. I'm gonna do something weird. This, but it's hard to do something creative here, though. Very hard to do something creative. I mean, how do I do something creative? I want to do something creative, but I'll just play f5. So this will be my attempt at being creative instead of playing standard. Also, I don't want to use too much time, because if I use too much time, plays a4, okay, e4. Maybe I'll go c5 here. I think I will, actually. Let's go c5. He takes, I take, and I go knight d5. I mean, this is probably still very dry. I can also just take and go c5 too. I'm gonna do this one, actually. Why not? I think just c5 anyway. I mean, it's kind of annoying to have to like play your main stuff in these tournaments, but again, it's life. He's secretly doing recon. Yeah, but the argument always when you play top level chess is that it's on white. There are less ideas with white than with black. So white is the one who has to prove it. Black is the one who just has to defend, basically. So that's kind of the moral of the story, is that basically with black, you try to just be solid, and it's on white to prove it. I don't know if queen c5 is right, but it looks right, because I just dropped back and I have bishop f6. It goes bishop b2. I can play bishop f6. Knight d5 looks good too, but I don't know. Rook c8. All, I mean, so many good moves here. I'm just going to go here, I guess. That's actually the general rationale that top level players use, is that it's more like it's on white to prove it than on black. Like, there are less white ideas than black ideas. So, you know, if white proves it and white draws the game, it's like ho-hum fiddle-dee-dum. Let's just go here. But it's very much on white, so there are less ideas with white than black. So when white shows something, it's a net negative, versus when was black, you show something, because you with black, you're always happy with a draw. Dubov's not streaming this. No, he's actually got a bad position here, though. I think it is left for the seven. Thing of the mistrustful for the six. I do want to focus, though, because I think I'm doing well here. I have rook d2. I have rook a c8 also. What about rook a c8? What's wrong with that? Knight b5? No. What's his move? Queen a1 is his move, and then rook d2. I don't see it. Let's do it. Because everything's guarded here. I don't see it. I mean, bishop a3, queen b3. I might just be winning here almost. If bishop a6, I just take or take. Probably rook c3, take, takes, takes. Yeah. Okay, he goes a5. Kind of a desperado, it feels like. Now the question is, do I ignore it or not? I have knight c4 to keep the pressure on. I think I'm just going to keep the pressure on. Takes. Now, do I take with a rook? I do. So we have knight a2, queen b2, queen a1, rook d2. I mean, this looks so bad for white. And I'm way up on time, so this is where I should use time if I need to. Maybe queen a2, but then rook c6. I mean, it's still technically even material, so if he can find some way out, he plays rook d1. Okay, let's think. I should be winning, but again, I have time. I have time here. So I have time. So now is when I need to think. Okay, let's not throw this. Rook b8. What's his move? Knight d5. Knight d4. No. Knight d5. Queen b2. Wait, knight d5 takes. Yeah, I don't see it, so I go here. Isn't this losing? Wait, I must be. Am I missing something? I'm just winning material here, right? Wait, whoa, be careful, be careful. Okay, I just take. Okay, but I mean, come back. Okay, he's trying to play on. Now I go rook b2. Okay, I think I even just go h5. Let's go here. Yeah, we got the dub. Nice win. Thank you to big D 1080p for the prime, XX cranky cranking for the prime, Asher C for the three. Thank you so much, appreciate it. Yeah, pretty good. Good win. Let's watch the other big matchup between Fandoreen and Alireza. Alireza is winning here after king h7. Yeah, just rook g8. Okay, I'm probably going to play Alireza next game. I'm going to play Alireza with black. What do I do is a question. Thank you to Citrus JB for the two. Thank you to Sammy Aurelia with the prime. Do I play solid or do I go for everything? No, Alireza is going to win. Alireza is going to get to eight, get to seven. So I'm almost certainly going to play Alireza. I'm going to be black. If I lose the game, it's all over. If I draw the game, I mean, I'm in the hunt and I give Alireza a draw. I mean, a draw is, I mean, I don't think Alireza will win every game. But will I? Odds, I mean, I'm trying to think about what the odds are if I win. Because if I win, does that really guarantee that I'm going to win the tournament? Not really. I'm in good shape, but not really guaranteed. If I lose, I'm pretty much out. Draw, we're both just trying to. I'm thinking about the odds. I'm not going to play Savidler. I'm going to play Alireza. So I'm just thinking about what the odds are. Although I'm due white, and Alireza is due white, so maybe I don't play him. I'm trying to calculate the odds between, like, if I lose I'm out of it versus if I win it doesn't guarantee first. I'm trying to figure out how likely I think it is percentage wise if I win this game that I'm gonna win the whole thing versus like just 0% chance of winning if I lose. I'm trying to think which odds make sense. Not sure. Sack your queen early for a draw. Yeah. I don't know. If I lose, I'm out. If I lose the game, I'm just out. But if I win the game, that's it's not like I'm like guaranteed to win either. That's kind of the math that I'm working in my head. I'm just working out what makes the most sense. Thank you to ABQ Zach for the 400, but thank you Eduardo Carrera for the Prime. Oh, it's not that I'm nervous. I'm just trying to think about the odds. Because in these Title Tuesdays, like you always want to be in it at the end. Like that's the other thing. If you lose early and you're just out of it, it's a real bummer too. Thank you to Kitar for the gifted sub. Thank you so much, Kitar. Be like Magnus, play for the win. I don't know what the odds are. A draw basically means I have to win out. If I draw the game, I'm on 7 out of 8. Actually, no, that's true though. But there are only 4 of us who have given up half points, so we're not all gonna win. Tricky. Very, very tricky situation. I'm not actually sure what the correct decision is. Oh, I actually get white. Oh, I thought I was gonna get black. Wait, I get white? How do I get white? He has more points and he should alternate color. Wait, how am I white? That doesn't make sense. With white, I'm obviously gonna play to win now. Or am I? Which one do I want to do? I mean, I think I have to play to win now with white. I think I just have to, yeah. I just have to play to win with white. I was thinking about which line to play. I wasn't really sure. I'm going to do this one. I don't remember if it's playable here or if it's with A4 or A5. Bruce. This is pretty standard stuff, by the way. Nothing really original here. Let's go Bishop E3. I think I was actually supposed to play H5 there. Now I can take and go knight e3. I'm going to take and go knight e3. Probably I play h5 and knight h4 if I can. You mean juice, not Bruce, right? Let's go h5. I think the idea is to go knight h4 and g3. He's trying to go a4. Am I really that concerned is a question. I don't know if I am. I don't actually think I am, so I'm just going to go G3 and knight H4. Bruce. Probably I'm going to go knight H4. Okay, it goes there. I don't think that really concerns me because I go rook H1. I want to go knight H4 anyway, so I'm not really that concerned. Although he's got F5 here. I misplayed this. Although I still have rook h4 and b4. Okay, it doesn't take advantage. Okay, let's go knight h4. I have to do it now. If he gets f5, I'm just lost. Maybe I go b3. Okay, he's trying to go knight d6. What's knight d6 doing exactly? He wants knight d6. Okay, so h6 is no good. f4 is a move. I don't really want to play it. It's very bold, but you know what? At some point, I kind of need to just go for it, probably. At some point, you kind of just have to go for it. Maybe I just go knight f5 and g4. Whatever, let's just do this. Don't know why I did that, actually. But I'll play g4 here. Try to hold. Yeah, I saw knight f7, but I thought I had like h6 at some moment too. Let's go here on queen g3, I guess. Okay, not queen g. Yeah, actually, let's just go queen g3. At some point, I'm going to go b3 and maybe f4. Let's go b3, stop c4 pushes. Let's go f4 and takes. Very balanced position, probably pretty drawish, I would say. Maybe drawish is the wrong word, but pretty hard for either side to do much. I mean, but yeah, for the content, I have to go for it here. Maybe I can go slide over and go like rook f2. Both sides are very set in their play here. That's kind of the problem. I mean, I can play. I just go here and takes. And rook f2. I'm probably going to play d4 at some point if I can. He takes, which is actually kind of surprising to me. Didn't expect that. I mean, it's probably still a draw, though. That was kind of surprising that he did that to me. Not that I can really do anything special because of it. I want to go knight d5, knight f4 maybe. Let's go here. That's a good move. Oh, that's actually, I just missed that. Wow. Just missed that completely. Now it's probably just a draw. Back to being very flat and dry. I mean, you can try b5, I guess. He does try it. Let's go here. I'm just headed for another pretty... there's just not much I can do here. I'll go here. That's probably wrong, but... Let's go here, maybe. I really need to... I would love if I could somehow guard this pawn, but this weakness on h5 is such a problem for me. I'm probably going to make a draw here. I'm up on time. I really want to play, but can I play here? Try C. That's too. It's probably too risky to go for broke here. Yeah, I think it's just too risky. Even though I'm up on time, it's just too risky. Or is it? Try to get sneaky here. Okay, he just ignores it. I really want to go e5. I mean, I don't even know why I did this, but okay, let's go. What am I doing, actually? I feel like I'm trying to blunder here somehow. Let's go here. Yeah, it's just... Let's go here. Wait, I get my knight to f4 maybe. Wait. Wait, I get my knight to f4 here. Still probably a draw. Whatever, let's just go for it. I want to go for it. I'm sure this is wrong, but let's go here. Okay, 4, logical. Let's go here. No good moves for either side, really. This probably is wrong. Just got to move. There's just nothing for either side, I don't think. Okay, well, now I'm going to go for it. Although I just blundered that. I just blundered. It goes there. Got to move. What am I doing? I just blundered. I threw. Yeah, I totally threw. That was a good game. I knew that I should have taken the draw there. I just knew that it was the right decision. and I didn't do it. I just knew it was the right decision to take the draw, and I didn't do it. Oh, that's so frustrating, because I knew it was right. Yeah, I just knew it was right. I just threw that. Yeah, I threw that. E5 was a bad move, but you know what? I don't mind that, because I think what I did was right, all things considered. I just missed Queen D7. I just missed Queen D7. Yeah, you can't wait. Yeah, because you see, again, I did exactly what happened that previous game where I can't go for it, and then like I decided I'm not going for it, and then I shifted back mentally to where I wanted to go for it. E5 was right. Yeah, but I mean, EF6 might be fine, but I mean, it's just too with no time, you can't do it. There were five times you said the move the computer liked. No, of course he's good. I mean, I just should have made the draw, basically. But I had more time, and it felt like the right decision. It's already probably too late here. What I should have done is I just make the draw. Like, I just repeat right around here, 95, 93, and make the draw rather than wasting time. But, yeah. It was just a mistake by me. This is still probably a draw. What I should have done is I actually, even here, I should have just waited rookie three, rookie two. Just, like, don't do anything stupid and just sit and wait, and probably this ends in a draw here as well. But I just, like, I wanted to try. Rook F2 is the main blunder. Yeah, but I mean, it's already very hard to play here. Like, once I allow this, I mean, like, knight e, nah, I mean, it's too late. There's no chance. I can play e6. I can't win. No, I mean, that's kind of the whole point at the start, is what are the odds? Like, if you lose the whole thing. But do I... Oh, I should have taken. I missed... Oh. Do I have this? Oh, no, he's rook c... No, wait. Wait, not rook... No, rook a3. Takes, and it's playable, but yeah. No, I wasn't throwing for content, but probably it's still the right choice because of the situation. If I draw the game, I end up in a situation where there are two people at least who have more points, and I get two blacks. So I can't complain. I mean, he's got to win once. Like, every single time we played in Title Tuesday up to this point, I've actually beaten him. So he has to win sooner or later. Like, I mean, you can't win every time. What if I played Berlin? I was black, or I was white. But probably, I mean, really... What I did wrong was I just didn't sit. At this point, I should just make the draw, you know, basically take the draw, live to fight the next game. Although, again, two blacks, one white, probably it's not getting it done. Yeah. D4 was also probably a bad move. Yeah, D4 is not right. Knight H3. Very inhuman. Sevilla is also on fire. Yeah, I mean, if this is also the thing, like, if you think about it, if I draw, I'm headed for two blacks in these final two games against people who probably are very solid. So yeah, I also shouldn't have been white in this game. That's a mistake in the system, unless I missed something. Let me see. Firouzja, 2003, did he have two blacks? No, he didn't have two blacks, so the system made a mistake. He should have been white in that game because he was he had the higher points total, and he had played black, so he should have alternated on the higher points, but it doesn't matter. Yeah, 750 sandals flush, who cares? It's not really that big of a deal. I'm just annoyed that I allowed Queen D7, because at this point I should have just repeated. Just stick to the plan, don't mess around, and then I go E5. Yeah, unnecessary. Thank you, 24 Trevor White, for the two scraps for the 377. Jay Anu, thank you to Pongaman for the tier one. Thank you so much, appreciate it. Yeah, unlucky. Well, probably, if I'm being objective and unlucky was that I played that I had this draw early. I played this FM who was very solid. That probably was the actually the unlucky part. Because I got that really unpleasant pairing early, and the guy played very well, and that was a draw. Because that also put me in the situation where, if, say, I was on 7 out of 7, I could have easily made a draw. Yeah. Okay. Some people are getting banned now. Okay. Some people are getting banned. Chess.com is not down. but happens. Frustrating though, very frustrating. Yeah, queen d7 was a very good move by Alireza. I forgot that he could do it in that specific spot, because before there was another spot where I saw e5 and I think it was somewhere around here. Yeah, like here I think I saw e5, but then I realized it wasn't good, and then I just forgot that he has queen d7, and that sort of messes up everything. So if I just repeat rook e2 rook e1, it's better for black, but probably I could have salvaged it based on the time situation. No one's ever gotten 11 out of 11. Yeah, no one has. Thank you to Feral Impulse as well, thank you so much. So yeah, why am I not playing Lee Chess titled arena? I don't play those. I mean, I if I can beat Sevilla, no, but I lost that game, so I have 6.5, so it's over. Alireza did not lose earlier. He got that win from that losing position against another one of the Azeris. I don't remember which one. He could get 11 out of 11. Again, I think it's pretty unlikely based on the players who are at the top. I can win out, but basically what I want to see is from the odds perspective, I want to see if I draw that game and I win out, I get to what, 10 potentially 10, 9.5, 10-ish. I want to see what the winning score is after Alireza. Thank you to Silver Bopper Boppers as well for the 4 months, thank you so much. But life. No, I mean, I'm not that annoyed about it. It's just, it's unfortunate. I would also argue the losses to Artemiev were much more upsetting, because in those ones, I was much better, if not winning in both of those games. Whereas this one, basically, I should have just made a draw. But it's not like I missed some huge win, or there wasn't some huge turning point where I had some grand opportunities. So I'm not thrilled by it, but it's not as upsetting. The other ones against Artemiev, I mean, I'm not happy about. But this one was just like a situation where I made the wrong decision when I should have made a draw. But it's not like I missed a win. If I had missed a win, I'd be a lot more upset. Thank you to HB the man for the 4 months. Thank you so much. Well, I mean, the thing, you know, actually the point that I would make, Chris Brown, in regards to plebs saying these stupid comments, is that what it does is, like, this is exactly why, like, for example, I won't just randomly play Blitz against Alireza or Nepo randomly, because there's no upside. Like, if I win, and usually I have in the past, like, if I win, it's like, okay, it's just regular, normal, whatever. But if you lose a game, then everyone's, like, all out there, like, oh, you're so terrible, blah, 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 and just rambling nonstop. So that's actually why, like, I don't always choose to play these Blitz matches. It's for that exact reason. Because if I win, okay, nobody cares. If I lose a game or two, or I lose the match, everyone's just like, oh, you know, just rambling nonstop. Okay, let's go g6. At least now I can just play where I just go for broke every game. Let's go c5. Why am I playing the Beefeater? I'm probably going to get smoked oh my god, why am I playing the Beefeater? I'm playing the meme opening, and I've found ways to survive in this, but it's a very bad opening. Let's go here. Thank you, Greg Linton, for the 6. Hovannis for the 2. Thank you so much. Okay. This is so gross already. I don't even know what I'm doing. I guess I'll go here. Knight g4, maybe? Go here, maybe knight f7, knight e5. Meme opening, yeah. No, I generally don't. It doesn't bother me, but it's like, that's exactly why, like, sometimes I just don't bother, because there's no upside. It's like if I play and win, it's like, oh, well, that's, well, of course he won. That's to be expected. And then if I don't, everyone's just out there rambling. Yeah, f4 is a good move, and this could get very ugly very fast for me. Go here, and hopefully I can get a grip on the dark squares. Probably not, but let's try it. Do I think Artemyev has a good future like Fabian or someone like that? I mean, I think Alireza is obviously currently the strongest junior player. And just because of his age, definitely the biggest threat to someone like Magnus. I guess I live by the sword, die by the sword, as they say. Guess I go here and hope. I mean, my knights are not great. My bishop is terrible. If I can get king h8 and rook h8, rook g8, maybe I can use the open file and play this and try to survive. Mind you, it's pretty. I'm going to go here and rook g8. It's pretty gross. Although maybe it's not so bad. The more I look at this, the more I'm not actually convinced. I'm going to go here and bishop d7 and rook g8 maybe. Actually, the more I look at this, the more I'm not so unhappy now. So I'm up a pawn, and if I can get some kind of bind on the dark squares, it's maybe not so bad, actually. This game, probably I'll find a way to win. Okay, rook h4. First of all, there's queen g5, but I think I just go... Actually, maybe it is Dean. This might be quite dangerous. Let's see. I want to route my knight. Queen g5 is a move, but not a great move. I think I just go... I'm just going to go here and hope. So, because now he can't move the knight, because then it's mate in one. If rook h6, rook f8, maybe. If I get queen g5, I'm just better. Goes rook h5. Okay, so he's looking to go rook f4. Want to go bishop g4. It doesn't look right. Queen, actually, how do I do this? I guess I just go here. He's going to try to double up his rooks. I think I'm going to go rook f7 and queen f8 maybe. I mean, either he has a forced win here somehow, or I'm just going to consolidate my extra pawn and eventually win this game. That, however, looks like a bad move to me. Doesn't look right at all. Takes with the pawn. Okay. So now I need to use this knight. Maybe I go over. Okay, let's just go back. Oh, he's trying to line up a legendary triple. Oh, this could be quite Dean. Oh, he's got actual big threats, which I missed. Oh no, this is actually very problematic. I can defend with two rooks or the queen and the rook. Oh, I missed this. Uh-oh. Let's go here. This is very dangerous. But if he takes, I just take. Yeah, he's trying to get the legendary triple stack on the h-file. If my king was like somewhere over here, I'd be fine. But my king is very dangerous. It's very precariously placed. I still think I'm okay, probably, but it's very dangerous. Let's go here. Let's bishop d2. So he's trying to line up some kind of mate threat. Let's go here. Because he's got a mate. He's actually has a mate threat there. Queen h3, I thought he might do that. So maybe I'm just losing here. Wow. Although bishop h6, I have rook g4. Wait, this is kind of weird. Okay, wait, let's go here. I don't see his win. g7, takes, and I hold everything. He's got the legendary triple, but I'm holding it with my doubles here. Where do I want to go? I think I'm going to try to... I don't see anything. I'm just going to wait. I want to see what his move is. Okay, let's go here. Because bishop h6, I just take g2. go here. I'm probably gonna take. Oh, I missed that. Shoot. Just take and take, maybe. I mean, he kind of blundered this. I'm holding the glue. I'm holding the glue. I think I'm actually winning here because this. I think I'm winning. Let's go. No, let's just go back. Get the bastion and use my pawns. Let's just go. You just here. Let's go 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 here, and now we win the game. Checkmate. Civiller smoked Alireza. Okay, so yeah, so okay. So Peter's on a roll now. Wow. Wow. Again, you guys, this is why you don't play the Beef Eater. That's why everybody at home don't play the Beef Eater opening. It's a very bad opening. A very, very bad opening. Not recommended. So definitely not something you should do. I mean, I somehow won. I don't really know how I won that game exactly, but somehow I got out nicely. Well, he kind of blundered. Basically, I don't know. Somehow he should have. Maybe it already. I wonder what the. Let me see what the eval is after g5. I'm kind of curious. What is the eval here? Let's see. What is the eval after g5? Yeah, I mean eval plus 1.5. So what did he do wrong? He didn't go bishop e2 here. Oh, he missed the idea. The boat, he missed the boat. His idea that he tried to use later was really good. He goes here, rook h4 and bishop h6, and he just, okay, very dank, very, very dank. Instead, he goes for this, and it's still very good. Still very good, wow. Still very good here. Yeah, and now it kind of fades once he blunders this. Crazy. You know what's funny? Looking at the score, you know what? I actually made a big mistake. Because the field is so soft here, there aren't many people with high scores. So I actually made a mistake not taking a draw. Not because I lost eventually. But because the field is so soft, there are so many people on eight here that I made a big mistake. Because normally at this point, there are like three or four. There usually are like two people on nine and like three or four people on eight and a half. So I should have taken the draw also because it's too soft. I still could do it. I could still win two games and actually like somehow make it back, which would be insane. Thank you, Thriller, for the 300 bits. Imer PD for the two. Old school game for the two. Trying to lean for the two. Mr. Motsky, the 226, Bob Sagat. Thank you to Sir Clug for the tier one. Thank you so much. Yeah. I mean, hopefully I play Savidler. If I play Savidler and I can beat Savidler, that's my only chance. I need to play Savidler here. I need to play Savidler and I need to beat him. That's it. Oh, but I don't get Savidler. I get someone else. Okay, let's go e4. It's a little bit more disappointing. I was hoping I would play Savidler there, although I have 7.5 and there are enough people on 8 who he has to play. But all right, whatever. It's must win. We go for it. I'm gonna do something weird. I'm gonna do this and this. This is a Gata Kamsky favorite. He likes playing the Gata was always a big fan of playing the delayed exchange variation of the Ruy Lopez, and so I'm gonna, in honor of Gata, I'm gonna play it here. This castle. I do play the Scotch sometimes, yeah. Queen f7 was double x clam in my previous game. I think it was the only move, so kind of hard. Anyway, let's play like Gata with knight c4 maybe. Chess Warrior is not Gata Kamsky, but thank you. No, Chess Warrior is Noderbeck, Abdus Torv, another player who almost certainly will be in that Julius Bayer event, I'm guessing. Play knight e3. I don't know if I want to play a4. I think I'm just going to develop my bishop. I want to see if he's castling long or short. Okay, he's castling short. I wasn't sure if he was going to do that. If you can't play like God, play like Gata. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Play like Gata. Yeah. Gata played, when Gata was coming back and playing a lot of over the board chess, he was playing this very frequently. This was his go to against in the Ruy Lopez. I'm going to play g3. I don't know if it's best, but I'm trying to play very deep sort of conceptual ideas here. Okay, b5 seems a little bit weird. I can go knight a5, but I think knight e3 is fine. Because I can always take and go queen h5, or at least that's my intention. I can also go knight g2. I feel like I had a game in this against Etienne Bacro recently in another title Tuesday that was something very similar to this. Let's go queen h5. I'm almost certain I had something extremely similar, although it was much worse because Etienne got his pawn running to like f3. Okay, but this might also just be bad. Let's go here to go knight g5, maybe knight g2. I should have just played f4 probably. Why did I go f4 there? So I'm gonna go here. This is probably terrible. I don't know what I'm doing this game. It's king h7. Let's go here, maybe a knight h4. I do have c4 at the right moment as well. Still probably bad, but I mean, it shouldn't be terrible now after. Okay, he goes c5. I mean, I think I should go c4. f4 allows e4. I don't really love that. That being said, is it so bad? Probably not. So let's play it. I also have knight e3 here. Oh, knight e3? Let's play knight e3. And knight f5 and takes. Maybe not the best move. Probably I should have taken. Well, let's go for it. I don't know if it's right, but let's go for it. Because I'm going to get a lot of pawns in the center here. Also, it's a must win, so it's a great decision to sack. They asked Torx for the prime and X Juice God for the prime as well. Must be the right choice. Okay, so he does this, so obviously I take. Now the question is, do I go rookie 6 or do I go rookie 3? I think I go rookie 6. Do I or not? Okay, don't blunder. Oh no, rookie 6, he's got knight. Oh, he's got weird stuff coming in here. Well, the rookie 6 looks right. Oh, then he's got knight c4 and knight f. Wow, bishop d5. Crazy. Okay, let's just go here. Yeah, I expected that. Let's go rook c1. So take. Rookie 8. Probably a very good move. Oh, wait. No, it's not because d6 hangs. So he doesn't have rookie 2 even. Let's take. No, I'm doing well if I don't blunder. That's all I have to do. Just don't blunder. How hard can it be? Just don't blunder. He goes knight c8, which I think is not a bad move, but not the best move. Let's go here. I'm up a pawn, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, or 5. I'm up a pawn, so I should be doing well here. I have rookie 1, maybe. Let's go here and trade. Yeah, just don't blunder. I mean, how hard can chess be? Just don't blunder. Of course, now I allow rook c4, and just like that, I did blunder, of course. And the worst part is my blunder now. Oh man, is that I probably can't even win in this endgame now. Well, whatever, I have to do it. I mean, I have to just do it. It's 97. Okay, let's go. That's not the right move, I don't think. Let's go here. I mean, I get rookie 2. I also have f5, f6. Okay, how do I do this exactly is the big question mark. Very tricky. Let's go here, maybe? A knight d4? What am I doing? I'm just throwing again. Oh my gosh. Bishop a8. Okay, let's go here. I don't. Bishop a8 was not the best move. Got to be very careful with how. What about knight c3? Oh, knight. Nah. Let's just go. Let's go here. I have to get knight c3 in somehow. I've got to stop knight g4 to 2. Can I take? And I check and take. This might not be winning, but it's worth a shot. G4 maybe? And I have a checkmate threat? I think I'm winning here. I mean, G7? Or do I go G4? Let's just go G4. I can check. Let's just go here. It's a bad move. Actually, maybe it's not. Cause I have a checkmate up here. Here. Yeah. No, I'm winning. Cause I have check and mate. Okay. This must be winning. Let's go. Check. Let's go check. Let's go here. Check and mate. There we go. Nice. There we go. Thank you to Tomei for the 10 months. Yeah. It's a win. It's a win. Not a good win, but it's a win. Okay, who did Savidler play? Savidler drew against Paul from Siberia. So you know what's insane here? I'm gonna have a shot if I play Savidler or Paul from Siberia to win the whole thing. Maybe not, because one of them could win, but I have a shot, which is just insane. Who's Alireza playing? He is playing. Where's Alireza? Wait, what happened to Alireza? Did he win? Wait, did he just lose? Wait, what? Oh, he lost to Paul. Oh, he lost to Paul from Siberia. Wow. Amazing. Oh, wait, sorry. It's St. Petersburg, not Siberia. Sorry, it's St. Petersburg. Okay. Wow, that's amazing. So Alireza, he wins that game against me and then he loses two in a row. That's insane. Okay, well, I'm gonna have a shot. I just have to win the last game. If I win the last game, I have a chance. Paul from St. Petersburg is Paul. I think that's Anisimov. It's not, Paul isn't his name though. His name is Artem Anisimov, right? Or no, it's Pavel Anisimov. Wrong one. Same difference. Pavel Anisimov. Same difference. Anyway, actually, wait, Artem Anisimov is a hockey player. It's Pavel, it's not Artem. Anyway, yeah. Pavel, Artem Anisimov is a hockey player, right? Yeah, that's why I'm confused. Yeah, it's like yes. it's like something sounded wrong there. It's like, yeah, okay. All right, thank you to Oxfinger for the 2 months. Thank you so much, appreciate it. Yeah. I can still win. I know. I'm gonna have to beat one of these two guys, and if I win that somehow, I think I tie for first, which is ridiculous. Yeah. How many rounds? There's one more round. So if I think I have to play Paul or I have to play Paul or Peter, one of the two of them. All dozen NHL fans getting rowdy in chat. Yeah. Yeah. Thank you to Shorty Smalls for the 2 months. Thank you so much. Okay, one more to go. One more to try and bring it home. Okay. Oh man, I don't get to play either of them. Well, that's a bummer. Okay, whatever. Maybe they'll draw their game. I mean, do they play each other? They play each other. So okay, let's go here. Okay, we're gonna get a sharp game at least. This is all you can ask for. I mean, are they playing or not? They are playing. Okay. Okay, let's go here. Knight c3. D4, I'm just going to play d4 because I need imbalance more than anything here. So d4 seems like a good choice. Let's go here. Even if it's not the best move objectively, I need imbalance because a draw does nothing for me, literally nothing. So I'm just going to castle. So I'm going to go a5, maybe b6 here. B4, I just take the juicer. Let's go a5. I mean, you can try a3, I guess, but b6 or a4. Queen a4 seems like a weird move to me. Like a very weird move that I don't understand. Do I have b5 here? Wait a second. Okay, don't blunder. This is already very critical this in terms of this game situation. If I can move this knight and go c6, I'm happy. B5 takes, rook b2 is too dry. I need to win, so I can't do that. I think I'm just going to go here and bishop e6, d5. I don't know if it's right, but it looks reasonable. So if he takes, I go back and takes, and queen e8 maybe. I also have b5 maybe. I'm trusting this is okay. It might not be. Okay, he doesn't do it. Okay, I have f6, I guess. Because I have bishop d5. Okay, so he still can't take. So I take, take, bishop d5, and I hit the diagonal. This might be very wrong, though. I feel like I'm doing something wrong here. I think I have to go for it, though. We're already too late in the game. I have to go bishop d5 and f5. I have no choice. I also had g5 there, maybe. But I feel like I'm getting counterplay here, like c5, g5, f5. A lot of counterplay. Okay, does it. Wow, okay. Now, I have c5. I also have g5. I think c5's right, though. Let's go c5. f5, bishop e5 look too weird. Although maybe I should have thought more before just blitzing f5. I should have thought much more. Maybe it wasn't good, but I should have thought more on it. I should have thought much more before just instantly moving. Because now he just has knight c3 and I'm just down a pawn. Let's go here. Very poor by me. Extremely poor. Just threw this game. I had to go. Why did I not just go f5 or at least think here before playing it? Just f5. Okay, let's go. Let's go here. Okay, at least it's still a game. There's still plenty of time on the clock. I should have just played it. It's a must-win game. Why did I do that? No, not rook e8. That's a blunder. Just sidestep, maybe f5 next move. Down a pawn, but maybe it's not so bad. I have queen d5, rook e8 if he moves the knight. It's rook e1, okay. I kind of want to go f5 at some point, but not yet. Can I go queen e7? I think I can. Just take. Okay, goes there, so I take. I'm gonna play not beef. I'm gonna check. No, probably not. Let's go. Actually, let's just check and go queen d7 maybe. I have b5. I have f5 also. He has knight c4 maybe. But then rook e8. Okay, rook e8. Gonna have to go f5, f4 and hope that I can attack somehow here. Maybe rook e6. Maybe rook e8. Double it up. He's moving slowly, so I have some chances, maybe. That looks wrong. That looks very wrong somehow. Go here, rook c8. This looks very dangerous, actually. I guess I go rook c8, queen d3. 6 e3. Feels like there should be something, but I don't see it. 5 g4, knight d4. Whatever, let's just go here. And it feels like there should be some trick like knight e5. Queen f5. Man, unreal. Queen d5, king g1. Shoot, there are no tricks. Let's just go here. That's actually a bad move too, but whatever. I need some queen g4 or something. Trying to create something on this king side. He's moving very slowly. Rook c1. I really need like g4, f5, knight f3. Let's go here. It's probably wrong, but I need to go f5. If he gets his knight to d4, I have nothing, which is why f5, knight f3 was no good. I have knight e5 here, but I thought I could play like... Do I check first or do I go over? No. And also takes is no good. Knight e5, queen e4. Okay, let's go here. Maybe queen d5 next one. King g1, good. Knight e5? Wait. Knight e5? Wait. Let's go here. This is getting very dangerous now. Queen e2. Okay. Oh, let's go check. Okay, this is getting very... Queen d5? Wait, what's this move? His e4? Takes and rook d1, but then I take and take. I also have queen h... Oh. There we go, mate. Thank you to Gluten Water for the 100 bits. Greba for the gifted sub. Thank you so much. This is just a classic logic checkmate against Ludwig. Queen in the corner, and it's just checkmate because the diagonal's open. Amazing. Okay, so they're playing, right? Are they playing? Hopefully it's a draw. We hope for a draw. Savidler's losing? What? Savidler's going to lose? Wow. Wow. Okay. That's kind of amazing. Crazy. Okay, so I mean, I get second, I guess. I get clear second? Maybe. Oh no, there's still a couple of people playing. Let's watch their games, I guess. Yeah. Fandering loses. Danny gets a 9. Oh, this actually, okay, so it looks pretty good. I end up in a two-way tie for second. Not bad. I mean, I'm not happy, but after losing to Alireza, the fact that I can come back and win games and get in a tie for second is actually rather remarkable. That's kind of shocking. Wow. Second is the biggest loser. Yeah, but I mean, I thought when I lost to Alireza, I was just done. I didn't think I had any chance after that. Thank you to Chess Machine for 3 months. Thank you so much, Chess Machine. Appreciate it. Prize money, I think Andrake and I, we split like, I don't know, like we split. Why did I lose to Alireza? I mean, because like I didn't take the draw. I tried to overpress it. I'm very shocked because I thought that when I lost, I had no chance at the prizes even. I just thought there would be a lot of people ahead of me. It's not fair because I didn't play Paul from Siberia. And it happens. That's how Swiss tournaments go. Yeah. No, it's pretty good though. Pretty good. Look at the top 7-6 Russians. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 Russians. Yeah, and I'm the lone American flag in here. Danny actually came back nicely. Got 9 out of 11 though. I'm not wearing merch. No, I'm not wearing merch. If I took the draw, I would have won with tiebreaks. Again though, if I take the draw, the pairings are different completely. So you can't really say that. I mean, I could have played Svidler or like. I mean, the pairings would have been completely different. So you can't really say that. But anyway, I'll be right back. I'm going to run to the restroom. Give me a few. Is the tournament over? It's not quite over, though. I want to see the final standings. Yeah, just B7. Okay, there we go. Yeah, second place. It could have been a lot worse. I thought when I lost to Alireza, it was basically all over. So it's pretty good, actually. Find my way back into second place. Stop counting yourself out early. Well, it's just based on what I've looked at it. Normally, the winner... Wait, so you're saying that he lost in the first round? I mean, that's very weird, isn't it? Did he really lose in the first round? He lost a 2400 in the first round, then he won every game? Strange. Very strange. Who did he beat? He beat Shugarov? He beat Alireza, he beat Peter, and he beat Billy Kimba. Okay. I'm just going to take a look at this game. Yeah. Alireza was very skeptical. Oh, I'm just looking at the game. I mean, I haven't even looked at any of the games. I'm just kind of curious to see what the bar says. Alireza thinks something was going on. Yeah, I mean, I don't see anything really that weird. I would have to play him to have some idea, and I didn't play him. 77 accuracy first game. After that, he won every game with 95% plus. Thank you, Hitanga, for the gifted sub. Okay. I mean, chess.com will obviously look at it, but that does look weird. I'm not gonna lie. That does look a little bit weird to me.